you said that you had all brothers, right?
Yeah, all three older brothers.
Okay.
Yeah.
Man.
I know, it was rough, really
and you're
rough.
Still beating them up.
Oh, yeah.
There we go.
We used to wrestle all the time, like little. I used to beat the crap out of them. But I was like, I don't know, I didn't take, I was just like, oops, sorry.
You're good, we put a dolphin nose over it.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
I was like, I think it was good though, because it like molded me like to where I am today, like, you know what I mean?
So now, now they're like, okay, we won't mess with you.
Yeah, oh, now
sorry.
Especially they're like, do that move to me again? I'm like, no.
So how much do they love that you are a wrestler now?
Oh, they love it, yeah, that's awesome. And they have, so my two older brothers have two kids each, a boy and a girl. So they're like so into it. So you've met them actually. They've come backstage.
Oh, yeah.
They're obsessed with you guys.
It's funny because,
yep. No, yeah, I love bringing them back because like even if they've literally met like everyone. Like,
yeah.
I mean, they go back to school and they're like, we were with this one. You know, they show the pictures, and then every time, little Richie especially, when he comes back, he's like, get up. I'm like, you met him already. He's like, I know, it's fine, but it's so cute because they just like they love it.
I was so excited.
Yeah, but what were we talking about? What were we talking about before? About the... Oh, so yeah.
Monopoly.
And they were very strict, like, with me, like, growing up. Like, so, like, now it's cool. Like, they've accepted a lot throughout the years. But, like, between them, my dad, it was, like, insane.
Yeah.
Like, I used to, like, love, like, crop tops, you know? Like, I still do. I always show my stomach. My dad's like, what is that? What's the point of that? Like, why do you gotta show your belly button? I don't get it. Like, I was like, it's the style. Like, so I'd like change at my friend's house.
Oh, your backpack's so full because I have more clothes in there to change into.
I have my whole outfit that, it was bad.
I really can imagine bad. Just having heart attacks.
I was in eighth grade, and Gary, the one that we're 18 months apart, he was in ninth grade. So our middle school and our high school were right next to each other. So I like had a boyfriend, whatever. It wasn't anything serious. Like, I mean, eighth grade. Garrett Burns, his name is.
Garrett Burns.
We still, like, if I see him today, we always still laugh about the story. So we're like coming out of gym, and gym, I guess it was like eighth period or whatever. Mm-hmm. And we like got to exit like out of the gym, like where the, kind of where like the turf and stuff was, where the high school. And all of a sudden, like, we're holding hands, like, walking out. And I see my brother and his friends, like, come, like, running. And I'm like, I had a bad feeling, but I was just like, oh, God, get real nervous, right? My brother just comes right up to him, punches him right in the face.
No.
Just drops him.
No.
And I was just like, oh, my God. And he's like, don't ever talk to my sister ever again. Or don't even look at her. And I was just standing there. And I just, like, ran to the bus.
What did he even do?
Nothing. He was holding my hand. And he was so sweet. God. It's funny because he just got married to, like, my friend that we grew up, like, they went to high school together. And every time, like, I tell this story, like, we always laugh. And Gary, my brother, thinks it's hilarious. He's like, oh, that was so funny, man. I'm like... Like, no.
You got punched in the face.
Yeah, like.
So what happened, like, the next day?
Oh, like, nobody wanted to talk to me, of course. Like, I had, like, no friends because they were all scared of my brothers. And then the two older brothers, when I got into high school, the ones that they, like, played football with, the younger, like, the juniors and stuff, they said, oh, watch out for my sister. But those guys just wanted to hook up with me anyway, so it was just whatever.
We'll look out for her. It's like, Jesus.
Yeah, it was pretty bad.
But I'm just imagining... If I'm in eighth grade, I got my little girlfriend, I'm so excited.
Right.
Oh my God, my girlfriend's so hot, I'm gonna hold her hand. And then I just see this man running at me, like,
just running.
And then just being punched in the face.
It's like out of a movie. Like, I wish I had it on video.
Okay? Eighth grade, I hit the ground, I'm crying.
Oh, yeah.
I'm
he was hurt. Like, and he's a little, like, he was just kind of like doofy at the time. So he was just like, he was like, oh, like, he started like laughing, I think, bad. And I'm like, I'm sorry, but I'm like, well, that's the last that I'll be seeing you, I'm sure. It was bad.
I really hope the girl that he married was like his next girlfriend.
I know,
like,
right?
He's like, hey, do you have any brothers? No? Okay, perfect.
Okay, we're good.
Cool. My God.
Gosh.
So like,
yeah, it was bad.
So that was like throughout all of your school existence.
Yeah.
Until they went to college. Yeah.
So then, and then I kind of like rebelled a little bit. I dated one of his friends and like just karma. Yeah, it was bad. Yeah.
Like, but, beat your friends up.
Yeah. But then they were like okay with it later on. I ended up like, and like my ex-fiance was my older brother's good friend growing up.
Oh, wow.
Yes, it was really weird how it worked out. But out of all like my brother's friends, like he liked me being with him because he was a really great guy.
Yeah.
So like worked, you know, whatever. But it's just crazy. Like now, thank God they're better, but just like, who would have thought? Like it was wild. Parties were the worst. Like, you know, like going to like parties, high school. And like my brother, the second I'd walk in with like a group of friends, get out. Nope, get out. And I'd do the, oh, come on, like, please, like, let me hang out. And I'd have to leave. It was miserable. So bad.
That's the life that I want.
Oh, yeah.
Just protect your younger sister,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
Protect her from everything.
And the best is, like, my mom and dad would just be like, well, you know, you won't regret it when you're older. Like, they got your back, whatever. I'm like,
yeah.
And yeah.
And it worked out.
It worked out. Yeah.
See?
Yeah.
So, oh my God.
Crazy.
Can we talk about this? What, I can't remember, we were doing like the old school shoot, and you told me that you and your brother both got voted having the best butts in high school.
How'd you remember that? I told you that?
Yes.
Yeah, nicest cheeks.
Yes, nicest cheeks.
Who, what, like, superlative. It was superlative. It's like, who does that? My dad wanted to go to the print, like, go to the school and kill the principal.
Yeah.
Because he's like, I had to take a picture with my butt with another guy like this. Like, my brother got it
that's
too.
That's in the yearbook. That's what the best thing is, because like when she's like, oh yeah, you know, I won best cheeks. I'm like, oh okay, cool. She's like, yeah, then my brother won it the year before.
Well, my older brother, the middle one, won it when he was in high school. Like, we're 6 years apart.
It's so insane.
So he actually got best looking and nicest cheeks. I was like, I didn't get the best looking. I just got the nicest cheeks. I was like, whatever.
So you go I'll tell him. He's like,
yeah.
I got you.
Yeah.
I got one
of
you.
Yeah.
How is that
Isn't
a thing?
That so
as a
crazy?
Of nicest
I wonder
cheeks.
If they still do it. I feel like they don't. I feel like.
I hope feel like they it was, do. And
I know.
Now they're getting found out.
I know, right?
Like, nobody
I know.
Knows
I, gotta, I have
secret.
The yearbook at my house too. I gotta find it. Yeah, it was really me and Jesse Eversano, this kid. We both and we had to take the picture, and my dad hated it because he was like, "This." I was like wearing like jeans too. It wasn't like I had like my ass cheeks hanging out.
Yeah. It was like a little half-cut shorts, like.
But I thought it was the craziest thing. I'm like, what kind of superlative is this? Like,
because there's a teacher that's in charge of like the yearbook crew.
Right.
And they're going through everything. Okay, you know, funniest, most likely to succeed.
Right,
most
all
likely
that.
To be a comedian.
Like, didn't get
nicest
any of that.
Cheeks.
Right.
Yeah, that makes it. Best looking. Yeah, cool. That's just.
Yeah, cool. And the kids vote.
Yeah.
So we all voted. So, like.
So now you know, like, you have a majority of the senior class.
Right.
Saying, yes.
Yeah.
She has the nicest butt.
Yeah.
Like.
Which is so funny.
It's
so interesting. And but I feel then, like there's not that many schools that probably have that.
No.
I feel like.
I'd imagine no.
Like, and. I don't know, it's so funny, Yorktown High School.
Yeah, but then on the flip side of it, like, how good did you feel when you won it?
Oh, so great. I loved that. I was like, that's right. And this is before I was, like, working out. Like, so I just, you know, born with a good butt, whatever.
When you win the superlative, I can't remember, how much time is left in senior year?
It's, like towards the end, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah. You're like
a month or two left.
Yeah, so I was like, walking around, you know?
Yeah, just like, you know, I'm going to wear these.
I'm gonna really show it off now.
Yeah.
But the best is when we did, my daughter's a WWE superstar, I went and, back to my high school, and I'm just like thinking, like, as I'm walking through, like, of course, like, I'm the most, you know, famous that came out of this high school, but it's like they didn't pick most likely to succeed. It was like nicest cheeks.
Yeah.
So I'm like, awesome, cool. Look at me now.
Like, show
yeah, I know,
this
right?
This is a picture of
like,
you.
This is, yeah.
It's like football state champion trophy. Here we go. This. And then right here in the middle,
nicest
our
cheeks.
Prize possession.
Mandy Rose. Oh man.
Oh, that's so good. That's so
crazy.
Good. Yeah, we didn't have that superlative.
You didn't, right? No.
No, not at all. What else did you do in high school? So you played lacrosse?
So I played a lot of sports like before high school, and I kind of stopped like 8th grade, 9th grade because I just like danced. I went on to like Yorktown, I was in the dance company.
Oh, really?
So I was like really like into dance, so I kind of stopped the sports and just went to dance.
Okay, so like what kind of dance were you
I doing? Did everything. I did hip hop, modern, ballet,
Wait, can
jazz.
You tap dance?
I did tap when I was little, but it wasn't my cup of tea.
Okay.
It was, I did it for like a little while, and then I was like, nah.
Yeah. Okay. To have dancing.
But hip hop was like my I know. It's crazy. Yeah.
So with your background in dance, did you watch So You Think You Can Dance?
That was like newer. Was it around like
2004-ish?
Okay. So, I mean, I remember watching it a little bit. Okay. Yeah.
But you weren't like into like,
but I wasn't
dance
like really
in shows.
No.
Or,
okay. Not really.
Yeah. You're into
I just
your own.
I liked like we had like our dance company was cool. We like would put on shows and like it was just like fun, like a bunch of my friends, we would do it. And, I wasn't like into it like that much.
Yeah.
I mean, I really loved playing sports and I shouldn't have stopped, but I was just like, I got a little boy crazy in high school. And then I was just like, I like to dance.
Okay.
And then I was like, yeah.
You wanna come see me dance? I have the nicest cheeks.
Oh gosh.
So, okay. So do you still like do dance stuff every once in a while? Like once you got into like fitness stuff, that was like your.
Yeah, then it was like fitness, and I didn't really continue, you know, besides like in the club and stuff, you know. Besides like in my room, just like hanging out, but I didn't really continue after that.
So when did you start fitness?
So I went on.
Like the way you're smiling, like there's a good story.
There is a good story, yeah. So I went to college, Iona College. I got my bachelor's
in. What college?
Iona, in New Rochelle.
Okay.
I got my bachelor's in speech language pathology. Mm-hmm. So I was like doing, first I was doing early childhood education, then I went on to do that, and then I had to get into a master's program, but I didn't get into like one that I wanted to go to. It was like too far at yeah. that point. So I was like waitressing and bartending at a restaurant. And one of the waitresses that was like really into like fitness and like really into like running and biking, she was like in incredible shape. And she was a little older. She's like, you know, you should get into competing. And I was like, eh, like I've seen, you know, a little bit before, but I wasn't really like that crazy. I'm like,
yeah.
So I started training with a coach, and obviously I was like, fell in love with that because I was like seeing my body like go through these changes, and like I always was like a little bit like thicker, you know, nice cheeks and whatever. Like, turn that kind of into muscle, if you know
gotta,
what I mean.
You gotta.
So I was always like, I was always had like bigger legs and yeah. stuff, but then I ended up like getting more like muscular and like actually like loving my legs because I was a little like insecure when I was younger.
You gotta love the thickness.
Yeah, no, I love the thickness, yeah. but like I didn't, you know, when you're younger, it's different, like, you know, and of course what you're influenced by and stuff. So I started like getting all this muscle, and I was like, oh, this is awesome, whatever. So it was random. Like she was like, my coach was like, yeah, you're gonna do the Boston show. It's it was in like April or something. And she's like, I was like, yeah, whatever, okay, I'll just try it. So like I'm very like, just I'll just like do things, but I don't really like think about it that much. Yeah. I'm just like, yeah, I didn't really know much about it. I went and did it. I got on stage and like I placed first, but like I had no idea what I was doing. Like I knew how to like, I learned how to like do the walk yeah. and everything, and I had like the confidence, but yeah. like other than that, like I didn't know what I was getting myself
like,
into.
Hey guys,
yeah, but I like you. I was like, oh wow, first place. So I got like my pro card right there, and I was like, oh, this is cool. So then I went on to do Worlds, which that year I didn't place in Worlds. It was like kind of close. It was like April to like August, and mm-hmm. I was like too lean, and I ended up getting like a different coach, mm-hmm. and then did Worlds the following year, and that's when I was the Bikini World Champion, yeah. 2014, which was cool. And then I got like sponsorships and stuff like that, and was, you know, building my following and working with all that stuff. And then then I got recruited for Tough Enough. Mm-hmm. So, and here I am now. Crazy, right? Crazy.
Tough Enough is a hell of an experience.
This is a crazy experience I've ever like, but it was a lot of fun. And like Sonia and I always talk about it. Like it was. Like, I don't know, it was just such a crazy experience. I'm so glad I did it because yeah. it's one of those things, like, I feel like when I'm older, I could, like, talk about, like, I was stuck in a house, like, not even at the barracks.
Yeah, yeah.
Next to the PC, like, just, and, like, with a bunch of people we didn't know, but we had such a good group, too. Like, we all, like, had fun. Like, mm-hmm. like the first night we finally got out, we were, like, caged animals because we couldn't wait to get out of that
yeah,
place.
Yeah,
and we just, we had so much, yeah, and it was just such a good experience, though. It was cool. Like, I learned so much. It was, like, the competitions were, like, crazy. Like, I would never think I would do some of the stuff we did. Like, swim in the swamps with alligators.
Yeah.
Like,
that's crazy. I'd have been out.
Yeah,
couldn't
no.
do it.
Oh.
The previous season that they did right before that, so I was almost on that.
Really?
Yeah, because it was FCW at the time. And they said that they're bringing it back Tough Enough, and they're like, oh, we want some people that are like, that know how to wrestle,
right.
that we know, like on the show. And so they came down, they're like, oh, you guys are all gonna like audition for it. And we're like, we already have jobs.
Right,
like,
what do you mean, why?
What? And so they like took our promos, and then they took like six of us, and then like whittled it down, and it was like me and Hunico, well, Sin Cara.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
And so they took us to California, and then that's when they like took our phones,
yeah.
and signed the contract. So like we had to like get fired to get the new contract for Tough Enough.
No.
So we like got fired so that we could sit in this hotel in California for like
did
a
you
week.
Want to do this, or was it like more just
yeah.
like yeah
yeah because like once we were talking about it, it's like, oh no, it's like a good opportunity,
right.
obviously,
yeah,
to,
yeah.
And like they're like, if you end up getting it, like it's fine that you used to work here.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it'll be a fun story.
For sure.
But yeah, so as we were going through the process, and they took our phones, and like you stay in this hotel room, you cannot talk to anybody. Like we'll put you in a van and take you to the gym, but you don't talk to the other people that are in the competition.
Oh
like,
yeah, it was.
We don't want you to know anybody.
That was the worst.
Yeah, I didn't know all that stuff happened, and so like seeing it come back, like I was always curious. Like, did they do that stuff to you guys?
Oh yeah.
You couldn't.
It was the worst when they'd bring us to TVs and stuff. They'd be like, don't even like. It was like John Cena walking by, and we all like wanted to say hello and shake his hand.
Yeah.
And they're like, don't even look at him. Like it was like that crazy. I'm like, this is weird. At one point, I was like, no. I'm not gonna like not say hello to people. Like
yeah.
it was just because they wanted us. They like put us in a room and they didn't want us to leave.
Yeah.
And like, I think they were more nervous too as to like some of. I mean, I don't know about all of them, but like some people they didn't want like, you know, just embarrassing themselves. I
yeah.
don't know, just like certain things. But it
yeah.
was, yeah, it was crazy. Like,
yeah.
like the no phones and the, oh my gosh, it's
just
wild.
Be on total lockdown.
Just, yeah.
I can imagine once you finally get out, you're like,
oh my
yes!
God, we went so wild that night. I don't even remember.
We're hitting the town.
Like, let's go.
These 2 days straight, you're just, I got the nicest cheeks. Nicest cheeks.
Oh my God. That's so great.
Okay, but you're here now.
Yeah, I'm
you're
here now.
It, having a good time. What is, I'm gonna ask you a big question. Mm. What is your favorite thing that's ever happened to you in your life?
Favorite thing?
Like favorite life experience.
Favorite life experience.
Yeah.
Hmm. That's a good one.
Yeah. Make you dive deep.
Yeah. Hmm. This is hard.
I know.
Favorite life experience? Oh my goodness.
This is the last question.
So
you get a big one. I'm trying to think of mine too.
Yeah. Gosh.
I'm trying to think. Hmm.
So, like, I don't know why it's such a hard question. Like, you would think that this would be something that you would,
that would
be
hit
able
the forefront
to,
of your mind. But I think the longer it takes you, the harder it is. Like, you've had a solid life.
Right, for sure.
You got so many good things that have happened to you. So you're blessed.
So I'm like, I'm
blessed.
Extremely
hashtag
blessed. Hashtag blessed. I am blessed.
Mine.
I need some help.
Mine would be, this would be, yeah, I'll say best because it altered, like, the path of my life, I guess. So, I had a wrestling match senior year, and I won this tournament, like the turkey duels.
Right.
And the guy who was in that weight class before me, who I couldn't beat, who was insane, Mike Hudson, was incredible, right?
Mike Hudson, okay.
And so my coach comes up to me after I won the tournament, and he goes, hey, how do you feel? He goes, I go, I feel like Mike, because Mike always won it. He was like my idol when I was in high school. He goes, I feel like Mike. And he goes, why? You should feel like Austin.
Right.
And I was like,
revelation.
Look up to people, but be the best you can be. Like,
yeah.
And he just was just saying that. It was junior. He was just saying that to me. He was like a real hippie guy. He, like, you know the band Fish.
Yeah.
He's the guy who, like, followed them around.
Oh,
for, like,
my gosh.
Like an amazing wrestler, and just like,
right.
When he said those words to me, like, he didn't realize that, but he, like, legit changed my life completely.
That's amazing.
That. So, like, that was when I realized, like, no, it's just bet on yourself.
I love that.
Don't be anybody else. Like,
yeah.
All these lessons rolled into, like, this one sentence.
Yours was so good. See, now it's hard because now I need to, like, I can't top that.
You can.
I feel like I really have to, like, think.
Just some, you know what, anything that just made you feel real good.
Yeah.
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 I'm waiting for you to go, when I won. Nicest cheeks.
That would have been so good.
That changed my life
forever. I wouldn't be sitting here today if I didn't get that award.
I got the support.
I had all the support and the confidence class. Oh, that's so great. Oh my gosh. I mean, to be honest, probably like when I won the show, only because when I got my pro card, when I did the fitness.
Yeah.
Because I feel like that was the stepping, like that was the first, like, part of my life where I was like, wow, like, this is, like, I loved doing what I was doing in school and stuff like that, but I felt like that was, like, something I was doing for myself, and I felt, like, so, like, rewarded and, like, I achieved something, but then, like, it started my path to, like, everything I've got to this day, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And, like, my ex-fiance was, like, a huge supporter, and, like, but the second, like, he saw me on stage, and he's like, she's gonna go somewhere with this, and he got me into, like, wrestling, because he was a huge fan growing up, because I wasn't, like, a huge fan growing up.
Yeah.
So, like, he kept saying, he was like, oh, you could be, like, Trish Stratus, you gotta go do this, blah, blah, you know, all this stuff, whatever. So, he was, like, a big supporter and, like, pushed me to, like, get to where I am now, but, I would probably say that, just that, because that was, like, the first time then I, like, realized I wanted to, like, do more with it, you know what I mean, just do more with it, whether it was fitness or just, you know, influencing, like, other people and, like, being, like, you know, a good role model. So, like, that was, like,
I'd
probably go,
I mean,
with
that. It's a huge deal, because it's something where you got to put the work in and you saw it pay off.
Exactly.
And you know, like, you did it.
Yeah, exactly. And then it was something that I was like, oh, I'm good at this. It's cool. Like, I was good at, like, going to school, but, like, I mean, it was, like, I had to, like, study, like, my ass off. I mean, it wasn't, like, so it was, like, it was cool to, like, find something that I was, like, passionate about, but also, like, good at, like, just organically, too.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, yeah.
That's a great answer.
Thanks.
Great answer.
Thank you.
Here we go.
I got to show off my nicest cheeks, too, on stage.
Like anything where I can use my assets.
My assets.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? No pun intended.
Well, thank you, Hamburgers.
Oh, thank you.
I appreciate you being on.
Of course. Thanks for having me.
Great. Of course, of course. Where can they find you on social media?
You can find me on Instagram at Mandy Sachs. Twitter is WWE_MandyRose, I think. Sometimes I'm
We'll have the links.
Yeah, we'll get the links
down below.
Yeah.
Just click the links, follow.
Follow the links down below.
Make sure you're supporting her and all of her cheeky endeavors.
Oh, I like that. Hey.
All right, we appreciate you guys watching. Make sure that you are subscribed to this channel. Hit the bell so you get the notifications when new videos pop up. Tell your aunts, your uncles, your friends how much you love Hamburgers.
Hamburgers.
And show your support.
Please do.
Until next time, always and forever. Oh, and the link for Demandy's Donuts will be down there too.
Yes. Don't forget
subscribe.
To follow our YouTube channel.
Yes, do it. Do it. Go click it
Thank
now.
Thank you.
Click it.
Click
until.
It. What?
Click it, yes.
Click it, yes.
Until next time, always and forever. Keep it tight.
Yes.
Yeah.